Hi everyone, we are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session, and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder, your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right after this class.
Hi, everybody. So are you all excited for today's class? Yes, good job. I'm seeing you after almost a week. So, okay, do you all know which class it is today? Yes, that's right. It's a science class. So before we go ahead, let me ask you, are you all taking care of yourselves? Yes. Good job. Are you keeping yourself hydrated? Good job, everybody. Okay, so since it's our science class today, how many of you all have attended it before? Okay, that's quite a few. And how many of you are attending it for the first time? Okay, no problem. So I'm pretty sure you're going to have lots of fun in the class. So let's get started. And let me tell you all not to forget, always invite your friends, okay? You know why? Because even though this is a virtual platform of learning, we all are going to have lots of fun. And just like we used to have fun in school with our friends, we are going to have fun in our virtual classes. So do not forget to invite your friends and let's get started. So today, what we are going to learn about is the different spheres of Earth. Okay, now there are four major spheres of Earth, that is geosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. So these are the four. Geosphere, that contains the rocks, comprises of the rocks. Hydrosphere comprises of all the water bodies and all the water that's there on Earth. Atmosphere comprises of the gaseous layer and biosphere comprises of all the living things that are there on Earth. Okay, so it is basically the reason behind life on Earth. Okay, all the life that's there on Earth, it comes under biosphere. So we are going to do all of this in detail. So are you excited to learn about it? Yes? Okay, good job. So what I want to do is I want to show you all a video. Are you all ready to see it? Yes? Oh, that's very good. So let's go ahead and let's start with our class. Yes? Okay. Okay. Can everyone see my screen? Yes? Okay, so let's get started. So today we are going to study about something that's called geoscience. Now, geoscience is also called as earth science. And as the name suggests, it is the study of earth. Okay, so we are going to study about geoscience, which is the study of earth. Now, earth is quite a complex system of interacting with rock, water, air, and life. Like you can see over here, it's a complex system of interacting between the rocks, the air, the water, and the life. Now, when we talk about this, let me tell you all, the four major systems of Earth, like we discussed before, are geosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere. So let's start with geosphere. What is geosphere? So Earth's geosphere is made up of metallic core, solid rock, and molten rock and soil and sediments. Okay, now coming to hydrosphere. Hydrosphere is nothing but all the liquid that is there. One second, let's just go a little behind. Yes, so geosphere is all the metallic core, solid rock, and all the molten rock, the soil and the sediments. Okay, so let's just go through it all over again. So it comprises of geosphere, it comprises of hydrosphere, that's water, atmosphere, that's air, and biosphere, that's all the living things on Earth, that is human beings, and underwater life. Okay, so let's study in detail about all of them. When we talk about Earth's geosphere, it is made up of the metallic core, solid rocks, and also molten rock. It also comprises of soil and sediments. Okay, so we need to remember metallic core, solid rocks, molten rocks, and soil and sediments. Okay, now let's come to the next thing, that is atmosphere. Now, atmosphere is nothing but a mixture of gases surrounding the Earth. Easy? Okay, now coming to hydrosphere, we have various forms of water. I mean, they are water is present in various different, not forms, but various different bodies that are there. Okay, so hydrosphere includes water in all its form, that is ice. Then we have water vapor, we have liquid water in the atmosphere, right? So we have a lot of things. Now, the liquid water that is there, it also includes waters in oceans, lakes, rivers, waters in the soil, and groundwater, correct? So it includes everything. So we are going to keep aside any form of water. And also, if you have attended our previous classes, you all will know that Earth comprises of 99% of water, and it's only 1% that is the land. Yes, so water forms like the huge part of Earth, correct? Okay, now let's go a little ahead and let's see what is biosphere. Biosphere comprises of Earth's living things, which can be found in many parts of the geosphere, the hydrosphere, and the atmosphere. Okay, so this is the water, and this is, when we talk about atmosphere, what are we talking about? We're talking about the birds that are flying, okay? And let me tell you all, it is not only underground, that is the, or on the ground, that is plants in geosphere, hydrosphere, which has fishes, or atmosphere, which has birds. It is also us humans. Humans are a part of the biosphere, and human activities have a very important impact on all the four spheres. Yes, so I think we are done with our first segment. Let's just revise this. So what we are doing today is geoscience, and geoscience is nothing but the study of Earth. Now, Earth comprises of four major spheres, that is the geosphere, the hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere. When we talk about these four spheres, geosphere is nothing but the rock part of the Earth. Hydrosphere is nothing but the water part of the Earth, be it in ice form, water vapor form, or the normal liquid water form that is in oceans, rivers, lakes, or even in the soils, underground water, everything. Then we have atmosphere, which is the gaseous layer that surrounds the Earth. And then we have biosphere. Now, biosphere is nothing but the living things that are there on Earth. It also comprises of the living things in geosphere, that is the, what do we say, whatever, the plants that are grown in geosphere, then hydrosphere, the fishes, atmosphere has birds, and also humans. Humans play a very important role in the geoscience, and humans can have a major impact on all four spheres. Okay, so yes, that's about it in our first part. So it's a quiz time. Are you all ready for the quiz? Yes? Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to be posting a link in the chat section and in the comment section of YouTube. All you need to do is click on the link and get started. Yes, I'll give you 2 minutes and then we'll go ahead. We'll continue with the class. Okay, so let's go. Okay. I want to see who's going to top the scoreboard. So I would request all of y'all to give your 100% so that you'll come first. Yes, who does not want to come first? Everyone wants to come first. So that's a good thing. So let's see who's going to top our scoreboard. Yes? Good job, everybody. So I can see that most of y'all have started with your quiz, which is very good. Let's see who's going to top the scoreboard. Okay. Okay, someone has already completed it. Let's see if anyone else can break their record. Okay, everyone started competing. Good job. Are the questions very easy? Yeah, kind of. Okay, good. That means you've understood it well. That's very good. Good job, everybody. Okay, so just give me a thumbs up, all those who have completed, so that I know. Okay. Okay. Good job, everybody. Good speed. Okay, all those who are left, I'll just give you all a few seconds more. Yes, and then we go ahead. Good job. Then we'll do the quiz together, and then we'll go back to our video. Okay, is everyone done? Okay, so just give me a second and let us all solve the quiz together. Yes? Okay, can everyone see the screen? Yes? Good job, everybody. So let's start. Okay. Which of these is not a major system of the Earth? Hydrosphere, it is. Mesosphere, biosphere, geosphere. Which are the four important parts? Geosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, biosphere. Which one is not the part? Mesosphere. Good job, everybody. Well done. Okay, next one. Biosphere comprises of all animals, all plants, all humans, all of the above. Biosphere is all the living things. All the living things includes animals, plants, and humans. So it is all of the above. Good job. Very good. Next one. Hydrosphere does not include rivers, ocean, ice caps, none of the above. Hydrosphere includes all water form, be it ice, be it water vapor. So it is none of the above. Very good. Okay, next one. Which of these is not correctly paired? Biosphere, living beings. Very good, that's correct. Hydrosphere is water. That is also correct. Atmosphere is gas, which is also correct. Geosphere and ice. That's wrong. Geosphere is rock. So we got our answer. Good job, everybody. Very good. Okay, we got a power up. Let's move on to our last question. Okay, which of these planets have a biosphere? Mercury, Earth, Venus, Mars. The only planet which has living beings or anything living on it is our planet. That's correct. Earth. Very good, everybody. Good job. Okay, so with this, we are done with our first segment along with our quiz. And now what we are going to do is we are going to go ahead and watch the balance video. Are you all excited? Yes, good job, everybody. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's watch. Okay, before that, did you all enjoy whatever we've done till now? Yes, good job. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's continue with our video. Yes, okay, so just give me a second and we'll go ahead. Okay, is everyone ready? Yes. Now, before we start, let me tell you all, Earth has a lot of energy. Okay, now all the process that takes place on Earth, in Earth, is all related to the energy. Now, the energy flow in or on Earth has two major sources. One is the sun and the other is the core of the Earth, that is the interiors of the Earth. Yes, basics are clear. So all the processes of Earth are because of the energy flow in the Earth. Shall we go ahead? Okay, so let's go ahead. All the Earth's, okay, shall we start? Yes, we shall start. All the Earth's processes are the result of energy flowing and the mass cycling within and between the Earth system. Now, Earth's energy comes from two main sources. One is the sun, and the second is from the Earth's interior, that is the core of the Earth. Okay, clear everybody? Very good. It is this flow of energy and the cycling of matter that produces chemical and physical changes in the Earth's material and changes in the living things. What happens because of this flow? It causes chemical and physical changes. Okay, in the Earth's material and also brings about changes in the living things. Very good, very good. Now, let's go ahead. Now, you know what is carbon? Do you know what is carbon? No? Okay, so carbon is a chemical element, okay? Now, what is the chemical element? Now, let's go ahead and let's watch, okay? So, let me tell you all, this is what is carbon. Now, carbon in large amount constantly cycles within the Earth's system of rocks, water, air, living things, and what we call fossil fuels. Now, what is carbon? Carbon are chemical elements or materials which are in abundance in our Earth's system, which constantly keeps cycling within the Earth's system of rocks, water, air, and living things. And we call these as fossil fuels. Clear, everybody? Now, how are fossil fuels formed? Fossil fuels are nothing but natural fuels that were formed millions of years ago. Okay, and how were they formed? When the dead animals and plants were compressed by the earth on the ground, these fossil fuels were formed, and we commonly call them as coal, oil, and natural gas. Clear, everybody? Yes? Okay, very good. Now, Earth exchanges energy with the rest of the solar system. Okay, tell me one thing, everybody. You breathe in oxygen, correct? Do you only keep breathing, or do you only keep inhaling it, or do you exhale it as well? You exhale it as well, right? You don't exhale oxygen, of course. You exhale carbon dioxide. But it's a give and take process. Similarly, Earth exchanges its energy with the rest of the solar system. Now, if it's consuming, if it's taking energy from the sun and from the interiors of the Earth, that is the core, don't you think that it will give out some energy as well? So it exchanges its energy. Now, Earth gains and loses energy and exchanges it with the solar system. So now Earth gains and loses energy through the incoming radiation of the sun's heat into the space and the gravitational forces from the sun, moon, and the planets. Clear, everybody? Now, the most important thing to remember here is Earth gains mass from the impact of the meteors and the comets into the comets, while it loses energy through the escape of gases into the space. Okay, so one very important thing to remember is Earth not only takes energy, okay, and mass, but it also imparts it. Okay, because you cannot keep taking. You have to give something in return, right? So it takes the energy and it also exchanges it. Clear, everybody? It's energy and mass flow. Very good. Okay, now Earth system interacts over a wide range of temporal and spatial scales. These scales may be microscopically small, okay, they may be very small, or they may be global in size, and that can last from a few seconds to billions of years. Okay, these impacts can last from a few seconds to billions of years. For example, ice caps, okay, all the physical and chemical changes we are talking about. Ice caps before were huge. And because of all the changes that humans, because of all our silly exploitation of resources, what is happening? And all the global warming that we are causing, ice caps are melting. So which were present in abundance, now they are very less. Okay, so now that did not happen overnight. It took quite a few years. I cannot say billions of years, but it took quite a few years for these changes to take place, correct? It can be changes that can take place instantly or which can take place over a period of time. These changes can be very small or these changes can be huge. Okay, clear everybody? Very good. Okay, it's the interaction between the Earth's system that has shaped Earth's history, and they will also determine Earth's future. Regions where organisms actively interact with each other and the environment is called their ecosystem. Now, before we move on to ecosystem, let me tell you all this once again. The changes, the physical and the chemical changes that are taking place in the Earth can be extremely small or can be huge. Okay, these can take place within seconds or it may take a long, long period of time. Okay, so these changes can be microscopic or macroscopic. Clear, everybody? Yes, so these changes have tell what has happened in what has happened on Earth in the history, and these are also going to determine our future. Yes, now regions where the organisms actively interact with each other in the environment are called ecosystems, right? So where all the organisms, be it microorganisms as small as bacteria, or be it huge fish, whale, or any animal, be it elephant, any animal, where they interact with each other, even humans, where they interact with each other is called ecosystem. Correct? Now, it is the ecosystem that supplies us with food, fuel, oxygen, and nutrients, and we need to sustain, and these are the things that we need to sustain life. Yes? So what is the ecosystem? A place where all the organisms interact with each other in the environment. And this ecosystem supplies us with food, fuel, oxygen, and nutrients, which is of essential importance to us to stay alive. Yes? Everyone clear? So what did we learn in the second half? We learned that Earth not only takes energy, but it also loses energy, correct? All the physical and chemical changes that take place on Earth can be microscopic or macroscopic, that is small or big, and can take place in seconds or over a time. And tell me, what are the two main sources of energy for Earth? That's right, it is sun and the interiors of the Earth, which is also called the interior core of the Earth. Very good, everybody. Okay, now what is ecosystem? Ecosystem is nothing but a place where all the organisms interact with each other in the environment. Very good. And it supplies us with food, fuel, oxygen, and nutrients that are of essential importance to us to stay alive. Yes, good job, everybody. You're so smart. You understood it in seconds. Very good. Okay, so it's time for our second quiz. What we are going to do is we are going to be posting the link in the chat section and in the comment section on YouTube. All you need to do is click on the link and get started. Yes, I'll give you 2 minutes and then we'll discuss it together again. Yes, let's go get started. I want to see who's going to top this. Now, you don't have to take any stress. It's going to be absolutely easy. Just you'll need to apply all the things that we have learned. Okay, it's more of application questions. So go ahead. Yes. Okay, I can see like almost all of y'all have started, and most of y'all, and quite a few of y'all at the end. That's very good. Have at least completed 3 to 4 questions, and the last 2 or 1 question is remaining. That's very good. Good speed, everybody. So I think y'all understood it clearly. That's more important, right? Very good. Okay, so we have quite a few people who completed the test together. That's very good. Good job, everybody. Okay, suddenly we have so many people completing it. That's so good. Very good. Okay. All those who have completed, just give me a thumbs up. Okay, that's good. Good job, guys. Okay, those who are still writing, it's okay. You all have time. Please complete it. Okay, I hope everyone's completed. Yes, give me a thumbs up. Very good, guys. So what we will do now is we will go ahead and we will solve the quiz together. Yes, okay, good job. Okay, can everyone see my screen? Yes, very good. Let's get started. Okay, so the first question is, all major systems of the Earth are a result of Sun's energy, Earth's energy flow, gravitational pull of the sun. So it is Earth's energy flow. Very good. Very good. Okay, next one. Which of these is the source of energy for Earth? Core of the Earth, both, that is core of the Earth and sun, or only sun? So it is both. It is sun and core of the Earth, that is the interiors of the Earth. Very good. Good job, everybody. Okay, next one. Biosphere is continuously going dash changes. Only microscopic, only short duration, macroscopic and microscopic, that is short as well as long duration, only macroscopic. What changes are we going? Short and long, right? So macroscopic and microscopic. Good job, everybody. Very good. Okay, next one. Active interaction between environment and living beings is called ecosystem, hydrosphere, atmosphere. Interaction between all the living organisms in the environment is called ecosystem. Very good. Good job. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, which of the following statement is true? Earth only loses energy, Earth takes up as well as loses energy, Earth only takes up energy. What did we say? We breathe in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. Similarly, Earth takes up energy as well as loses energy. Good job. Okay, so we are done with our quiz questions over here. Okay, so how many of y'all found this interesting? Oh, quite a few. And tell me, did you all ever know about all of this? Yes? Okay, some of y'all might be knowing about all of this. Okay, that's very good. But did you all learn anything from this? Yes? Good job. Very good. Okay, so now I have 2 fun activities for y'all. Let's start with the first one. So I want y'all to get an A4 size sheet and a pen, pencil, sketch pen, color pencils, eraser, anything would do. And let's start with our drawing exercise first. Yes, so I'll just be sharing it with y'all. Okay, can you all see it? Okay, all those who are ready with your stationery, go ahead and get started. All those who are running here and there, please go and get your stationery and then you all can start. You'll need to write your name, today's date, grade, and the name of the school. And also today's topic, that is spheres of the earth. Yes, let's go ahead and do that. And then I'll tell you all your, what you'll need to draw. Okay, is everyone done with all the details? Okay, let's go ahead. You'll need to draw a rectangle that will act as a border for you all. And then you'll need to draw this beautiful image. The rock will be your geosphere. The clouds and the rain will be your atmosphere. The water will form your hydrosphere along with the fish, because the fish and the trees together will form your biosphere. Yes? Okay, let's get started quickly. Can I give you 2 minutes to draw this? I think that's sufficient enough time to draw this. It's quite easy. Yes? Okay, go ahead. Let's do it. Okay, till the time you're drawing, let me just tell you all. Once you complete drawing this, don't forget to submit these, because I'm going to personally go and evaluate all of them, and I'm very excited to see what you all are going to submit. So make sure you all give your entries, and don't worry if you all don't complete it right now with me. You all can memorize, you all can just take a photo or something, and you all can complete it later. Okay, because you all have 2 days span to submit this, and I'm going to personally evaluate. I would like to see each one, and top 10 would get featured on our website. So I'm pretty sure you all want to get featured with us, right? And I really want to see how well you all have done. So don't forget to submit it. Yes? Good job, everybody. Continue drawing. Okay, is everyone done with the drawing? Okay. Oh, I can see some of y'all showing it to me. Good job. Very good, guys. Good job. Very good. Oh, I have such beautiful drawings. I would love to see all of them as the entries. So don't forget to submit it. The submission process is very easy. We'll take you all through it at the end of the class. But do not forget to submit it, okay? Okay, most of you are done. Very good drawings, everybody. Good job. So can we move on and start our next activity? Yes, do you all know which is the next activity? We always do this in our science class. That's right, it's our experiment time. And what we are going to do today is called the spiral convection. Now, do you know what convection is? Okay, before I get into that, let's go to the material list. We need an A4 size sheet, okay? We need a tall pencil, an eraser, and a small candle. It can be a tea light candle or any normal candle would do, small in size. Okay, all those who are ready with your material list, good job. All those who want to go and get the list, please go ahead and do it. Okay, till that time, let me just go through what is spiral convection. What is convection? It's not rocket science. It's very easy. When the air gets hot at the bottom, when it gets warm, it starts rising up, correct? And if it's rising up, what's going to happen? Obviously, the air that is cold at the top will want to come down, right? Because everything cannot go up. So the warm air rises up and the cool air settles down. That's so easy. So what is convection? Convection is nothing but the warm air rising up and the cold air settling down. Understood? Good job. Is everyone ready with the material list? Yes? Okay, let's go ahead. So we are going to watch the video first and then we'll perform it. Okay? So all you need to do is take an A4 size or any sheet, okay, which you'll have, and draw a spiral and make sure you'll end it somewhere. Okay, next, cut it And be sure, be careful that you don't chop your fingers off. So you'll need to be careful. If you want, you can take help from your parents. No problem at all. Okay. The next thing that you'll need to do is, after cutting the spiral, you'll need to take a thread and suspend it. Okay, there are two ways of performing this, and then light a tea light, and this will start rotating. Do you know why it's rotating? Because the hot air is rising up, cold air is coming down, so that causes a spiral effect. Second way to do is take a rubber or clay and pierce the pencil inside. Keep the spiral at the top and light your candle below. Again, as the air heats, it will start rising up, and as the cold air is getting pushed by the warm air, it starts coming down and settling down. Clear, everybody? Isn't it easy? Okay, let's go ahead and let's perform the activity now. Okay, so you'll need to take a paper and you'll need to draw the spiral. Make sure that when you are drawing the spiral, you'll end the spiral somewhere. Okay, once you'll end the spiral, let's make the spiral, everyone, first. Let's do it together. So you'll need to make the spiral first. Yes, is everyone done? End the spiral. It's okay. You don't have to keep on drawing the circles. 2, 3, 4 circles at the most are enough. Is everyone done? Give me a thumbs up. Good job. Let's go ahead. Next thing, you'll need to take a scissor and you'll need to chop, chop. Okay. Be careful. Do not chop your fingers. Okay. And try to cut it on the line so that we are neat. Yes. Okay, once you are done with it, this is how it's going to look. Okay, let's chop it. I'll wait for you all and then we will go ahead together. Yes, so let's chop it. And once you're done, just open it and show it to me so that I know how many of you all are done. Yes? Okay, is everyone done? Give me a thumbs up. Good job, everybody. Let's go ahead. Now what we are supposed to do is, now this is what maybe all of you all might not be able to do. You'll need to tie a thread and suspend it. Okay, if you all can, good job. Go ahead, suspend it. Let's see what happens. You'll need to suspend it with a thread and light a tea light candle below and to start rotating. Okay, if you all cannot perform the suspension one, you all can do the second one, in which you'll need to take a rubber or clay at the bottom and insert your pencil in. Okay, let's do that. Take a rubber or some clay and insert your pencil in. Done, everybody? Okay, once you'll insert the pencil in, all you'll need to do is at the top of the tip, you'll need to just keep it, the spiral. Place it properly so that it does not fall and get burnt. Okay, so place it properly at the top. Done, everybody? Okay, very good. Now the next thing that you'll need to do is take your candle and place it below, light it. Can you see the spiral starts moving? Yes, it did it work for you all as well? Good job, everybody. It might take a few extra seconds because the air will take some time to warm up, and then the warm air will rise up and the cold air will settle down. So don't worry, it will happen for you all if it does not happen immediately. Yes? Okay. Now, let me talk something in depth about this. Yes, let's discuss it in depth. Okay, now tell me, what will happen if we place 2 tea light candles? Thinking, right? Put on your thinking caps and tell me. Okay, let me tell you. If you light 2 candles, what is going to happen? The air will start heating quickly. Now, if it starts heating quickly, it will start going up faster and the cool air will start coming down faster. In return, what's going to happen? The spiral will also start moving faster. Yes? Yes? Good job. But what if we just keep 1 candle and we make the stick that we are using or the pencil taller? So the distance between the spiral and the candle increases. What will happen? It has increased. Now the air is going to heat at the same speed. But when it's going to rise, it's going to take some time to reach till the spiral, right? So if it's going to take some time to reach till the spiral, what will happen? the air will rise slowly, the cool air will start settling down slowly. In return, the spiral will also move slowly. Clear, everybody? Good job. You all are my intelligent kids. Very good. So are we clear with all of this? Yes? Okay. And do you know what? This reminds me of the previous classes that we had. We had learned something called tectonic movements, plate tectonics. Yes, if you all have attended our previous classes, you all will know. This is exactly what happens inside the earth. Okay, all the movements, all the shifts that take place inside the earth are because of the earth heating in from inside. Okay, the plate tectonics that happen, the earth moves. Remember how earth was formed? Yes, all the heat that is there inside the earth starts coming up, and in return, what happens when it suddenly starts cooling, all the plate tectonics happen and the water started rising and coming up to the surface. Remember that? Yes, so a similar thing that we can relate this to is the plate tectonics. Yes, okay. And let me tell you all, the next thing that we are going to do is a quiz time. So this is the last quiz for today. And let's get started. So we are going to be posting the link in the chat section and in the comment section on YouTube. All you need to do is click on it and get started. Yes, so I'll give you 2 minutes and then we go ahead and solve the quiz together. Okay, good job. All the best. Let's go ahead. Let's see who's going to top this one. I'm very excited to know. Even though you all don't top, okay, don't get disheartened. The main reason behind us doing the quiz is just to understand whether you all are clear with the concepts. Okay, so if you all have any doubts, you all can come back and ask to me. I'm going to clear all of them. So you all don't have to get disheartened. The main purpose of us to solve these is just to know whether your concepts are clear or not. And that's what's important, right? Good job. Okay, have all of you completed? Give me a thumbs up if you all have. Good job. Okay, so all those who haven't, I'll just give you all a few seconds because we're up with our 2 minutes and then we go ahead. Okay, so let's get started. I'll be sharing my screen. Let me know if you all can see it. Okay. So can everyone see my screen? Yes? Okay, let's get started. Okay, all application questions. What will happen if you replace paper mill with a beaker filled with water and oil in equal halves? The mixture will increase in volume. The heated water will rise up and settle down. After cooling, the mixture will rotate. Obviously, the heated water will rise up and settle down after cooling, right? Good job. I think this was pretty easy. It was all application, but if you all understood it, I'm sure you all must have got this. Okay, lava inside the earth is essential for movement of clouds, movement of plate tectonics or tectonic plates, movement of rivers. What is it essential for? Movement of tectonic plates. Very good, everybody. Good job. Next one, which of these is not an application of convection current? The windy atmosphere over a hilltop, the whistle of a pressure cooker, hot air balloon, heating of room by radiator. Where all is heat involved? Whistle of pressure cooker? Yes. Hot air balloon? Yes. Heating of a room by radiator? Yes. Where is heat not involved? The windy atmosphere over a hilltop. Did you understand this? Are you clear? Good job. So it's more of application, but I'm pretty sure you all will get this. It was easy, right? No problem. Okay, let's go ahead. What will happen if one more candle is placed? Rotation of the paper will increase. Rotations of the paper will decrease. Rotations of the paper will remain constant. We discussed this. What will happen? If we place two candles, air will get heated faster, so it will go up faster. Cool air will settle down faster. As a result, it will start rotating faster. So rotations of the paper will increase. Very good. Good job. If you've got this right, very good. You've applied it perfectly. What will happen if the distance between the candle and the paper mill is increased? That means if we increase the height of the stick. We discussed this as well. Okay, so if it increases, the hot air will rise slowly, cold air will settle coldly, so the movement will be slow. As a result, the rotations of paper will decrease. I hope you have got this right as well. Very good. At least you have understood it now. Yes, that's more important. Yes, these were a little tricky because these were application questions, but I hope you all understood it clearly now. Yes, good job, everybody. Very good. So I'm very happy you all understood it. And this was something really interesting and different that we learned today. Yes, it was a little tricky, but I'm pretty sure it's clear now. Yes, okay. So did you all enjoy today's class? Yes, good job. Will I see you all in the next class? Yes, I hope to see you all in the next class. And don't forget to get your friends. We are going to enjoy together in this virtual classroom. Yes, okay. And also, let me just remind you all, don't forget to submit your entries because I'm going to evaluate them myself. And I would really like to see all of them. Yes, and I'm going to feature top 10. So I think you all forget to send across your entries. So this time, make sure you all do it. Yes. Good job, everybody. Very good. Okay, so I'll see you in the next class. Bye.
Hi, everyone. We are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link, and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder. Your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right after this class.